गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन. दिस इज द सम वी विल डू नाउ. शोबित लिमिटेड इज कंसिडरिंग टू परचेस अ मशीन. तो शोबित लिमिटेड को वॉन्ट्स टू परचेस अ मशीन. टू मशीन्स ए एंड बी आर अवेलेबल एट द कॉस्ट ऑफ ₹120,000 ईच. Earnings after tax, but before the depreciation, see, Shobit Limited is considering to purchase a machine. They have two options available. They have two options in their mind, either to purchase machine A or machine B. They want to make a choice between two of the machines. Either they will purchase A or they will purchase B, and both of them are available at the cost of 120,000 each. मीन्स दोनों मशीन 120,000 का है. अब दोनों में से कोई एक खरीदना है. दे हैव टू मेक अ डिसीजन वेदर टू परचेस ए और टू परचेस बी. नाउ व्हाट इज गिवन? अर्निंग्स आफ्टर टैक्स बट बिफोर डेप्रिसिएशन आर गिवन. अर्निंग्स दैट इज प्रॉफिट्स आफ्टर टैक्स बट बिफोर डेप्रिसिएशन. अर्निंग्स आफ्टर टैक्स but before depreciation. So tax minus ho chuka hai, but depreciation has been added. So isko kya bolte hai? What is earnings after tax but before depreciation? Means this is the profit from which we have deducted the tax but not the depreciation. Depreciation is not deducted, only tax is deducted. So what is that profit called as? The profit from which tax is deducted but depreciation is not deducted. What is that profit called? Depreciation add karte hai. Tax minus karte hai, but depreciation add karte hai. What is it known? It is known as cash inflow. Means earning after tax but before depreciation is nothing but our cash inflow. This is what given is our cash inflow. So how many years information is given? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 years information is there. What is the returns? Machine A is giving 50,000 cash inflow in first year. Second year 40,000. Third year 30, 20, 20. How much machine B is giving return? 20,000, 30,000, 50,000, 40,000 and 40,000. Now, with this information, we have to evaluate using payback period method that which machine should Shobit Limited purchase. And one more new method here is given, payback profitability. Means we have to give our analysis, give our recommendations based on payback period and payback profitability. What is payback profitability? I'll explain you when we will be doing that. When we will be doing payback profitability, that time I will explain you. So now let us start our sum. Step one is to find out the cash outflow. Cash outflow. Cash outflow is how much? How much is the cost of the machine? How much money will go out? Now here there are two. So what I will do, I will prepare a table because here two options, two machines are there. Na? So I will prepare a table. Separately we will have to do. Na? Nahito, if we can do together, so I am preparing this table for machine A and for machine B. So what is the cost of the machine? For both the machine, the cost is same. For both the machine, the cost is same. So cash outflow will remain the same for if we go for any of the two. Matlab, if I go for machine A, then also I'll have to spend 1,20,000. If I go for machine B, Then also I will have to spend 1,20,000 because cost of both the machines are same, but still I need to make a decision that whether I go for machine A or I go for machine B. That decision I'll have to take. Now, step number two is depreciation, but no information related to depreciation is given, and this for profits 50,000, 40,000, this profits of A machine and B machine are already having their depreciation added. So we will not go for depreciation. Depreciation is nil or not given. Not given. And this can, there is no need to find it also. If we will write nil also, it is okay, because no information related to depreciation is given. So SCB depreciation already added. Why do we prepare depreciation? Why do we calculate depreciation? That is because we want to add it to reach the cash inflow. हम depreciation क्यों calculate करते हैं? क्योंकि depreciation add करके we will reach the cash inflow, we will reach the cash inflow reach करने के लिए, because when after tax profit में when we add depreciation we get the cash inflow, but यहाँ पे already cash inflow is there, so depreciation नहीं भी find करेंगे, करेंगे find या नहीं find करेंगे does not matter because we already have the cash inflow. Getting my point? Now we will go to step three. That is cash inflow. So cash inflow is there. We will do for machine A first, okay? First we will find out for machine A and then we will find out for machine B. Let us find out for machine A first. We require three columns. Year, cash inflow and cumulative. Correct. So year cash inflow, which is already given in the question, and cumulative inflows. Cumulative inflows. So what we will do? 5 year information is there. So we will copy all this and we will paste here so that our time is saved. And here machine A. We are finding for machine A. So we'll add all the inflows of machine A. Now what is the next step to find out the cumulative cash inflow? Now our next step is to find out the cumulative cash inflow. Year, 1 year ended and our total profit was 50,000. Second year ended and total profit is how much? 50 plus 40,000. How much is it? 90,000. Third year ended and how much is our profit? 90 plus 30. 1,20,000. Fourth year ended and how much is our profit? 1,20,000 plus 20, that is 1,40,000. Fifth year ended and how much is our profit? 1,40,000 plus 20, that is 1,60,000. Which got the cumulative? Any confusion here? First year end may profit tha 50,000. Second year end hua to total profit is 50 plus 40 equal to 90. Third year end hua to second year tak 90,000 profit hai. Third year mein aur 30,000 profit hua. So 90,000 plus 30,000 is equal to 1,20,000. Same way, fourth year mein 1,20,000 plus 20,000 is equal to 1,40,000. And when fifth year ended, 1,40,000 plus 20,000 is equal to 1,60,000. So now let us find out the cash inflow for machine B. Let us find out the cash inflow for machine B. I'm simply copying this. क्योंकि यहाँ पे मुझे क्या दो कॉलम नहीं, सॉरी हियर क्या दो चीज मेरे लिए रॉन्ग है, ओनली दिस टू. सो मैं यहाँ पे अभी मशीन बी के इनफ्लोस ऐड करूंगी. आई विल ऐड द इनफ्लो ऑफ मशीन बी मशीन बी के क्या कैश इनफ्लो है, दैट आई विल एड. नाउ आई विल हैव टू अगेन फाइंड आउट द क्यूमुलेटिव क्यूमुलेटिव इनफ्लोस. सो फर्स्टली फर्स्ट ईयर एंड हुआ प्रॉफिट वॉज 20,000, सेकेंड ईयर एंड हुआ प्रॉफिट इज 50,000, 20 + 30. थर्ड ईयर एंड हुआ प्रॉफिट इज 1,00,000. फोर्थ ईयर एंड हुआ 1,00,000. थर्ड ईयर तक प्रॉफिट इज 1,00,000. फोर्थ ईयर का प्रॉफिट इज 40,000. सो फोर्थ ईयर एंड होने पे प्रॉफिट इज 1,40,000. एंड फिफ्थ ईयर एंड होने पे व्हाट इज द प्रॉफिट? It is 1,40,000 + 40, which is equal to 1,80,000. So we got the cash inflow of both the machine A and B. Now can we move to our step four? Now can we move to our step four, which is payback period? What is the formula for payback period when more than 1 year's returns are given? What is the formula for payback period when more than 1 year information is given? Year before full recovery plus unrecovered amount divided by next year's cash inflow. This is the formula for payback period. Now we have to find for two machine. Machine A, what is the payback period? And machine B, what is the payback period? So now firstly, let us see हमें कितना पैसा outflow हुआ है. How much money has gone out? Machine A का भी 1,20,000 and machine B का भी 1,20,000. So first year में look for machine A. First year में 50,000 मिला. Second year end होने में 90,000. And third year end होने पे payback period मिल गया हमें. यहाँ पे formula लगाने की भी जरूरत नहीं है because third year में ही मुझे मेरा पूरा 1,20,000 वापस मिल जाते. So for machine A we will say what is the payback period. For machine A, payback period is 3 years. मतलब 3 years में we will get our money back. 3 years में we will get our money back fully. Now let us do for machine B. Any confusion here? Any confusion here? Machine A के लिए हमें when we go to our third year, we can see that we are getting our full amount. मतलब it is not in between the year. Payback period is not in between the year for machine A. It is exact 3 years. मतलब exact 3 years में हमें 1,20,000 वापस मिल जाता है. Now same thing let us apply to machine B. First year we got 20,000. Second year we got 50,000. Third year we got 1,00,000. Fourth year we got 1,20,000. Means in between third and fourth year, in between third and fourth year, we have got the payback period. So let us put our formula. Year before full recovery is 3 years plus 3 years plus what is the unrecovered amount? 1,20,000 मिलना चाहिए पर थर्ड ईयर तक उसे 1,00,000 मिला है. सो 20,000 इज द अनरिकवर्ड अमाउंट बिकॉज वी हैव नॉट गॉट एग्जैक्ट 1,20,000 इन द थर्ड और द फोर्थ ईयर. ये बीच में हमें हमारा पैसा मिल रहा है. थर्ड और फोर्थ ईयर के मिडल में या समवेयर in between, we don't know when, but in between it is. Third में भी exact third year में भी पैसा नहीं मिला है and exact fourth year में भी नहीं मिला. In between somewhere it is. So here what we will do, 1,20,000 minus 1,00,000, and what is the next year's inflow? व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट ईयर्स इनफ्लो, यहाँ पे थर्ड ईयर एंड फोर्थ ईयर ना, तो मैं इसको बोल्ड कर देती हूँ, हाईलाइट कर देती हूँ कि ये 1 लाख इज द अमाउंट व्हाट वी हैव रिकवर्ड. हमारा आउटफ्लो 1,20,000 है जिसमें 1 लाख मिल गया, तो अभी भी 20,000 मिलना बाकी है दैट वी विल रिकवर फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट ईयर इनफ्लो विच इज 40,000. नेक्स्ट ईयर्स कैश इनफ्लो मतलब थर्ड ईयर तक कितना मिला 1 लाख, और रिमेनिंग 20,000 में 40,000 में से लूंगी, तो हाउ मच इट इज कमिंग, 3 ईयर्स प्लस 20,000 डिवाइड बाय 40,000, हाउ मच यू गेट, 20 डिवाइड बाय 40 हाउ मच यू गेट, 0.5 मिलता है. 3 plus 0.5 बराबर, विच इज इक्वल टू 3.5 years. 3.5 years इज द पे बैक पीरियड फॉर मशीन बी. नाउ टेल मी विच मशीन टू परचेज, व्हाट सजेशन यू गिव टू शोबित लिमिटेड, विच मशीन इट शुड परचेज, ए और बी, which machine Shobit Limited should purchase, machine A or machine B? Yes, because the payback period is less than machine A, machine A should be purchased. So what recommendation you give to Shobit Limited? Machine A should, as per payback period, aise likhte, you can write any way. आपने कैसे लिखा है वो इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है, पर आपने सही रिकमेंडेशन दिया दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट. एज पर पे बैक पीरियड पीरियड मेथड, मशीन ए इज रिकमेंडेड टू बी परचेस्ड. Why? Because the payback period is less. A is recommended to be purchased as its payback period. Its payback period is less as compared to machine B. So this is in my words, you may only write machine A should be purchased. That is also correct. It is up to you how you give your recommendation. One sentence. But it should be correct is important. Words are not important. It is correct. It should be correct is important. So this is. Now one more thing is there. That is, they have asked for one more thing. That is payback profitability. Payback profitability. Now, what is payback profitability? If you pay attention, ये दोनों machine, जो machine A है, वो 3 years में initial investment वापस आ जाएगा, and machine B में 3.5 years में वापस आ जाएगा. But what about the profitability? आपने machine लिया, आपने मशीन लिया और आपको टोटल 1,60,000 वापस मिला, जिसमें 1,20,000 वाज द कॉस्ट ऑफ द मशीन, एंड द अबाउ व्हाट यू गॉट इज द प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी. मतलब दिस पेबैक पीरियड जो मेथड है, इट इग्नोर्स द प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी एलिमेंट, इट फोकसेस मोर ऑन कि हमारा इनिशियल इन्वेस्टमेंट कितना जल्दी हमें वापस मिला. सेम वे लुक एट मशीन बी, 3.5 years में 1,20,000 मिला, बट उसके बाद लुक एट आफ्टर 5 years हाउ मच अमाउंट इट इज गिविंग. This is giving 1,60,000 after 5 years returns, and this is giving 1,80,000 after 5 years. भले आपको आपका initial investment late वापस मिल रहा है, but you are getting more returns in machine B. Can you see here? इधर 1,60,000 ही मिलेगा, इधर 1,80,000 मिलेगा. So what is payback profitability formula? I'll give you. So it is total cash inflows minus cost of investment. Yeah, you may say cash outflow. Cost of investment or cash outflow. Now let us find out for machine A. Total cash inflows kitna hai? What is the cumulative? Total 5 years mein kitna mila hai? 1,60,000, correct? It is 1,60,000. And how much is the cost of investment? Cash outflow of machine A. Cash outflow of machine A is 1,20,000. What is the cash outflow, or you may say to cost of investment? 1,20,000. So how much is the payback profitability? It is rupees 40,000. It is rupees 40,000. And for machine B, what is the total cash inflow? Cumulative inflows kitna hai? 1,80,000. तो हमने इधर लिखा 1,80,000. एंड हाउ मच इज द कैश आउटफ्लो? हाउ मच इज द कॉस्ट ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट? इट इज सेम फॉर मशीन ए एंड बी, 1,20,000. सो हाउ मच इज द प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी? 60,000. नाउ विच मशीन इज गिविंग मोर प्रॉफिट? विच मशीन इज गिविंग मोर प्रॉफिट? मशीन बी. सो वी विल राइट एज पर पे बैक profitability method, machine B is recommended as it gives more returns as compared to machine A. Now again, what I am saying, up को सही कंक्लूजन, सही रिकमेंडेशन देना है. हाउ यू राइट इज नॉट इंपॉर्टेंट. यू कैन राइट एज पर पे बैक प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी मेथड, मशीन बी शुड बी परचेज, या मशीन बी शुड बी परचेज एज पर पे बैक प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी. इट इज अप टू यू हाउ यू राइट, बट द कंक्लूजन शुड बी करेक्ट. सो यहां पे देखो, if we see, we have just given our recommendations to the company. Now it is up to company to make a decision. Payback profitability ke hisab se jaake machine A select kare, ya payback profitability ke upar ja method ko refer karke machine B ko select kare. This decision will be taken by the company. We have given our recommendations. Got it? With this summit is also done. Thank you very much, everyone.